The Rav, the Rebbe, to learn Hilchos Beis Apchira, which is heard out in Sicha, it should be Torah B'Tzibur, Tzedakah B'Tzibur, Tefillah B'Tzibur. So everybody should give Tzedakah now B'Tzibur. And to learn Hilchos Beis Apchira today, we have the honor and schools to have a member of the Anhola Yeshiva Gdele, and the Menahalim Yeshiva Gdele, Rav Shmuel Kramer, which will give us some insight into the building of the Beis Hamikdash. Rav Shmuel Kramer, Bakasha.
Thank you very much. First of all, I want to thank a very Choshevim Roman, Rav Shmuel Zalmanov, for organizing it every night, the learning of the Beis Apire. It's Mekayim, the Rebbe Seiro, as well as its foils, and bullets, as we'll soon see. Well, learning Torah is always a good thing. Especially in the 3 weeks, it's even more special. Why? Because seeing the mishpati padev shaver b'tzaka through learning Torah, that's how Yerushalayim Eretz Yisrael will become tipodev. Seeing the mishpati padev, which is learning Torah shaver b'tzaka, tzaka also, and especially learning about the Hilchos Beis Apchira, as we'll soon elaborate on. There's a tanchume. The Medrash Tanchumi says, I'm not going to read the whole thing, it's long, but it says, Rav Shmuel Barabe said, that Eivishev said to the Eden, even though the Beis HaMikdash is going to be destroyed, and there won't be any more Kabbonis, but still, they should learn about the Kabbonis, and it'll be Maile, Al Nialechem Kilu the Kabbonis Atam Reiskim. And they bring a rai because the Eibishter told Yecheskel Novi, he showed him the Tzuras Habayis, he showed him what the Beis HaMikdash and all the measurements should look like. And he told him he should tell the Eden, he should give over to the Eden the measurements. And Yecheskel asked the Eibishter, he said, what's the use? They can't anyway build the Beis HaMikdash. What's the use of giving them all the blueprints and all the details? He said, better wait. When they're going to build the Beis HaMikdash, I'll give it to them then. So David said, no, he should tell them, because while they're learning about the Binyan Beis HaMikdash, it will be, even though they're in Golos, you hate Binyan Beis, it won't be bottled. It will be, they'll be as if they're building the Beis HaMikdash. So Lachari, you would think that learning about the Beis HaMikdash is like very similar, like as if you built it, but it's not the same. But since Torah Semes says that learning Hilchos Beis Apchira is as if you were building it, so it comes out that when we are learning about Hilchos Beis Apchira, learning about the Beis HaMikdash, how to build it, and all the details about it, we are actually building the Beis HaMikdash right now. It's al derech, kol ha'isik b'teiras eilo. It's not as if that your oisik in oilo, it's as if you brought the oilo, but it's not much as if you're bringing an oilo. And that's why we find certain halachas in davening where we say kabbonis, there's certain halachas, what you gotta say it at night, or if you have to say it standing, because it's as if you're doing the avoid of bringing a korban. And that's the same thing. By learning Beis Apchira, we are building the Beis HaMikdash. And the Yeshleimid Rebbe says that there's a mitzvah, Vosklin Migdosh, Veshachanti Beseichon. You have to build a Beis HaMikdash. So that mitzvah wasn't only for the generation of the Yidden in the Midbar that had to build a Mishkon, or later on to build a Beis HaMikdash. And it's not negayev now, the Deiris. No, it is negayev, because how do we build a Beis HaMikdash now? We don't have the ability to build a Beis HaMikdash, but through learning about the Beis HaMikdash, that's how we build it. You might ask, it's not the same. When they were building the Beis HaMikdash, you saw they put a brick and another brick, a stone and this, and it got built. But now we don't see anything. We're learning, but we don't see that the Beis HaMikdash is actually being built. We don't see how the Beis HaMikdash is being built. That we are going to see later. later when Mashiach comes, we'll see the Beis HaMikdash that we built now during the years of Golus. And this is also Merum is, and before every Sefer Rambam, the Rambam brings down the Apostle. Apostle from Tanakh. And before the Sefer Avodah talks about the Hilchos Beis HaPrira and the Avodah Beis HaMikdash, the Rambam brings down the Apostle, Shalu, Shloim, Yerushaloyim, Mishloyim, Avodah. He says, Shalu, we should ask, we should seek out the peace of Yerushalayim. What means Yerushalayim? What's the main focal point of Yerushalayim? That's the Beis HaMikdash. And he uses the Loshen Shalu, which is a dibur. We have to talk about the Beis HaMikdash, learning about the Beis HaMikdash. That's how Ram is, that even though the Beis HaMikdash is now Chorev, how do we rebuild it? By learning about it. And we find this thing that even though we don't have the Beis HaMikdash, but it's still learning about it is like building it. We find it in different halach, different din. We find about tshuva. Like tshuva, somebody, unfortunately, if somebody did something that you shouldn't do, so you have to do tshuva. Tshuva is you have to do vidui. You say chatosi, avisi, pishaiti. You say what you did. You say you decided you're not going to do it again. You're not going to do any averis again. So in the time of the Beis HaMikdash, on top of all that, you have to also bring a korban. But today that we don't have Beis HaMikdash, so you have complete tshuva. You have even without the korban, you have exactly the same kind of tshuva like you had in the time of the Beis HaMikdash when you used to bring a korban. Just as an aside, Rebbe says it's Arachim because Rabbi Shmuel said he wrote down in his book. I don't know exactly what he did, but he wrote down in his book that when Beis HaMikdash will be built, we'll bring Achatos Shmoyne from something that he did. So the Chayri, you see that it's not complete. So the Rebbe says, first of all, it's a Tzorokhi and maybe on Rabbi Shmuel, because you don't find anyone else that said that they're going to bring a korban later when Beis Midrash is built, only Rabbi Shmuel. So Meile Weiss says that it's the Shleim is the Tshuva, even without the korban. And just the Rechagav, he says that maybe good for Emperor, because in the time of Rabbi Shmuel, there was a possibility to build the Beis HaMikdash then, so that's why he said that if the Beis HaMikdash will be built, it'll bring a korban. But today, when there's no possibility, so you have complete tshuva, even though you don't have a korban. Al derech zeh, to become a ger, in the time of the Beis HaMikdash, you have to have the mila, Fila, you have to go to make a bris, and you have to bring a korban. But today, you can't bring a bonus. A ger is a complete ger, even though he doesn't bring a korban, and he's mechuyev in all the mitzvahs. The Rebbe says that this, what it says that a ger later will have to bring a korban is not to be mashlim, but it's for another reason that he has to bring a korban. But the gerus is bishleimus, even though you don't have the korban. Even though we don't have the Beis HaMikdash and we're not fixing the Beis HaMikdash, we're not doing, but still, but by learning, it's mamish like building the Beis HaMikdash. And with this, the Rebbe says, we'll understand something else. It says, "Benigay the Beis HaMikdash the lawsuit." There's a discussion how it's going to come about. Will it be built by a person, by Mashiach? Mashiach will build the Beis HaMikdash, or it will be min hashamayim. It will come down. So one of the ways how you could reconcile these two opinions is that there's two parts to the Beis HaMikdash. One part is that we know how to build, because we're learning now the Beis HaMikdash, we know how to build it. So all that will be built by Mashiach, but that's going to be clear. But there's certain parts that are not clear, we don't know what to do. So that part will be built by the Eibishter, which will come down in HaShemayim. Or in another way is that we'll build it the way as much as we know, And then Mashiach will be Megale, those parts that we don't know, he'll be Megale. He'll be Megale to be mashed in the Beis HaMikdash, and he'll be built by a person. And then Milmailo will come down, and the Beis HaMikdash, Shomailo, will be infused in the Beis HaMikdash that we built. And this is the Dugmes in Aldera. There used to be, there was a fire on the Mizbeah, and even though the fire came on Milo, nevertheless, it was a mitzvah, l'havim min ha'hedik, you had to light the fire on the Mizbeah, you had to do it manually. How could it be the two things? Because they made a fire, but there was a fire that came on Milo, that it infused it on the fire that was there. And the same thing will be by the Beis HaMikdash that will build it, but the Beis HaMikdash Shel Milo will come down and will come be infused in this, in the Beis HaMikdash. So from all this, it comes out, I wrote for a person how much it's important to learn the Torah Sabayis and the Torah Sabayis and to know all the details, especially now in the time of the 3 weeks, the Ben Absorim, when it was the Korban Beis HaMikdash. So the yearning for the rebuilding of the Beis HaMikdash is so much more, therefore how much more important it is that we should be learning these inyonim. And like I said, by learning these inyonim, we are actually building it, even though you don't see the results. I guess it's like every mitzvah that you do, your mamshach hagilya lekus here in the world, you bring down godliness into the world, you don't see it. You know, a person puts on film, the world looks the same before and after. But that's only because we don't see it. But it's actually happening that the Likus comes down with every mitzvah that we do. And the same thing is by learning the Beis HaMikdash, learning the Halachos of the Beis HaMikdash, we are actually building the Beis HaMikdash, even though we don't see it right now. But when Mashiach comes, b'mheira b'yameinu, we'll see how all our learning added to the actual building of the Beis HaMikdash that happened tonight.
Just to remind everybody again, we still need people for Siyumim, some volunteers, some people that go out from their hidden. Please come up and tell me if you have a Siyum. Starting tomorrow night, in Mirz Hashem, there will be a Siyum tomorrow night after Ma'ariv, Shabbos, after Kiryas HaTorah, Motzei Shabbos, and Sunday, and then it will be. I'm going to have to see my goal. Let's take it from Yad Mamish.
Oh, wait.